Hello, Carl here with Sustainability Theory News. We're over at beginningfarmers.org. They have an article from Sean Dembrowski. He is on YouTube and his channel is Edible Acres, a great channel for small-scale permaculture. He has, I think it's about an acre of land on a north-facing hillside in upstate New York, but he's still, despite all those limitations, he still has almost 100 or maybe more than 100 species of edible plants at this point. And he has an article on how planting fall perennials, it's a great time to plant them. They're going to start growing roots to get ready for the winter, to overwinter, to survive the winter. So right now can be a great time to do it, whether it's clones from existing trees, maybe you have some seedlings you want to put in the ground for some perennials, maybe it's some bare root plant cuttings from trees, or there could be all sorts of different types of plant propagation you can use. Now, again, I will link to this article in the description, but we're going to go to hobbyfarms.com. They have an article on tips for collecting wild seeds and preserving plant diversity. So if you want to grow some more native plants to your region, maybe you go for a hike in the woods and you find some shagbark hickory nuts, some hazelnuts, maybe you find some ginseng seeds. Well, maybe you'll want to pick some of those and grow them in your garden. Maybe you want to take a sample of a leaf and do some tissue culture cloning using petri dishes. I did a video on that in the past. There are a lot of different ways you can preserve plant life, but in this article, the author talks specifically about making sure you're not damaging the plant when you're trying to take the seeds. The rule of four, she talks about from the Cherokee Indians. If you walk through the woods and you see four plants, when you see the fifth one, go ahead and feel free to take some of those seeds, because there's already enough plants in the woods. Taking a few seeds probably won't hurt that species population in the area. Now, they also talk about knowing the place, knowing the plants, maybe some spread through rhizomes and seeds. Those you can collect as many seeds as you want. Usually it won't hurt the population. But also know what you need to do to get these seeds ready for planting. They may require scarification, which is sort of like simulating the digestive system of a bird. Like clover seeds, you need to scarify by putting in some warm water. I think it's around 90 degrees Fahrenheit for 5 hours or so. But other seeds, like elm trees, for example, require stratification, and walnuts as well, which it's sort of like a 3 month cold period. You can usually keep them in the fridge as long as it's not quite freezing. A lot of people like to just bury them under about 4 to 6 inches of mulch and let them just sit all winter underneath that mulch, so they don't quite freeze, but they get cold enough to stratify. So those are some tips for planting fall perennials and other wild foods that you may find. Of course, if you'd like to see more news headlines like this, subscribe to my channel. If you want to read more about it, these two pages will be linked in the description. Have a great day.